बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम स्टूडेंट्स, इन टूडेज़ टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस दैट हाउ इंटरपोलेशन ऑफ डाटा कैन बी फॉर्म व्हेन इंटरवल्स आर ऑफ अनइक्वल लेंथ। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस दैट व्हेन डाटा इंटरवल्स आर ऑफ इक्वल विड्थ, देन वी हैव यूज न्यूटन ग्रेगोरी फॉरवर्ड एंड न्यूटन ग्रेगोरी बैकवर्ड फार्मूला फॉर इंटरपोलेशन। नाउ इंटरवल्स लेंथ्स आर अनइक्वल, सो द कॉन्सेप्ट दैट वी विल यूज फॉर इंटरपोलेशन इज डिवाइडेड डिफरेंस, एंड सो बाई यूजिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डिवाइडेड डिफरेंस वी विल यूज फार्मूला ऑफ न्यूटन डिवाइडेड डिफरेंस एंड देन लैग्रांज डिवाइडेड डिफरेंस टू for the interpolation of the data. Now firstly discuss what is the divided difference. The difference is find by taking into consideration the change in values of arguments is called divided difference. This is the definition of divided difference. Now we explain it. Consider we have data with the table values of x and y. Values of x are from x1, x0, x1, x2 up to so on xn, and for value of x0, x1, x2 there exists value of function y0, y1, y2, up to so on yn. These values are given, this is the data that is given in the table. Now length of each interval is then the intervals length x1 minus x0, x2 minus x1, and so on xn minus xn minus 1 are unequal or not equal, or we can say that unequal. Then we will define it first divided difference, second divided difference. Then what is the first divided difference? First divided difference, then first divided difference will represent with delta 1. In Newton Gregory formula, our forward interpolation sign was forward and backward was changed. Now first argument for x0, x1, for first two values will be delta of x0, x1, that will be written as y1 minus y0 over x1 minus x0. Similarly, for next two values, for x1, x2, divided difference formula can be written as delta of x1, x2 is equal to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. This is formula to find out first divided difference for each two values. Now we move toward second divided difference, del 1, del 2. Now we will talk about second divided difference. Then second divided difference is written by del 2 and it can be find out. In first divided difference there involves two values. In second divided difference there will involve three values in each interval. First interval will be x0, x1, x2. Second will be for, now for this interval, delta of x0, x1, x2 will be written as delta of x1, x2 minus delta of x0, x1 over x2 minus x0 point. And we know delta of x1, x2 is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1 value, and x0, x1 is y1 minus y0 over x1 minus x0 value. Similarly, third divided difference will involve first four value, and it will be written as delta of x0, x1, x2, x3 will be written as delta of x1, x2, x3 minus delta of x0, x1, x2 over x3 minus x0. This is the third divided difference. As similarly, we can find out nth divided difference for nth term. Now we will derive Newton divided difference formula with the help of the concept of divided difference for unequal intervals. So now the formula of Newton divided difference can be defined as f of x is equal to f of x naught plus x minus x naught delta of x naught x1 plus x minus x naught x minus x1 delta of x naught x1 x2 plus up to so on nth term x minus x naught x minus x1 up to so on x minus xn into delta of x naught x1 x2 up to so on xn term. Here delta of x naught x1 is first divided difference, x naught x1 x2 is second divided difference, and delta of x0, x1, x2 up to so on xn n is nth divided difference. Now a question is given and we have to use Newton divided difference formula firstly to form out its polynomial, and then with the help of that polynomial we have to find value of f of 8 and f of 15. Data is given for values of x, there exist corresponding values of y. As these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 values in the data, so our table with divided difference will move up to 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and 5th divided difference. So this Newton divided difference formula for 5th term can be defined as f of x naught first term, for 2nd term x minus x naught first divided difference, x minus x naught x minus x1 into second divided difference, plus x minus x naught x minus x1 x minus x2 into third divided difference, plus x minus x naught x minus x1 x minus x2 x minus x3 and fourth divided difference, plus x minus x naught, x minus x1, x minus s2, x minus x3, x minus x4 and fifth divided difference. With first divided difference, there exists one term for second divided difference, two term exists for third divided difference, three terms in multiplication for fourth divided difference, fourth term in multiplication and fifth divided difference, there exists fifth terms in multiplication. Now, we will construct with the help of formula first divided difference, second divided difference, third, fourth and fifth, we will formulate our table, and these values substituting into this table, we will get polynomial, and by using that polynomial, substituting value of x is equal to 8 and 15, we will get desired answer. Now, as first divided difference, we have defined that formula of first divided difference is if for values of x0 and x1, it will exist as y1 minus y0 over x1 minus x0. Now, by using this formula, this is y0, this is y1, and this is x0, this is x1. So we can say here 100 minus 48 divided by 5 minus 4. This will give us answer 52 divided by 1, that is equal to 52. So our first divided difference value is 52. Similarly, for 4, 5, 7 and 100 and 249, this formula can be defined as 294 minus 100 will give us 194, and 7 minus 5 will give us 2. From here we will get our answer, that is equal to 2 9s are 18 and 2 7s are 14, so here we will get 97. Similarly, for these two values, 900 minus 294 divided by 3, we will get from here 202. For next, 1210 minus 900 divided by 1 give us answer 310. And for last value, 2028 minus 1210 divided by 2 will give us 409 answer. These are first divided difference for each two term, and this is formula for each term, and each term formula is given as. Now, for second divided difference, formula is written as delta of x0, x1, x2, that is equal to delta of x1, x2 minus delta of x0, x1 divided by x2 minus x0. Means here we can say that this is delta of x1, x2, 97 minus 52 divided by, these two values exist between these three values. So this is x2, this is x0, 7 minus 4 give us 3, and here from here we will get 45, that is 15. So from here, from these values, we will get here 15. Similarly, when we are talking about these two values, we will get 202 minus 97, and their initial value is 5, final is 10, so 10 minus 5 will give us answer 105 divided by 5, that is equal to 21. So here is 21. Now for these two values, 310 minus 202, we will get here 98 and divided by 11 minus 7 is 4. So from here we will get our answer is 27. Similarly, 409 minus 310, that is equal to 99, and 13 minus 10 will give us 3. So from here we will get 33, and this is 33. These are second divided difference. Now for fourth divided difference, for third divided difference, we will write it as for fourth values x0, x1, x2, x3. That can be written as del of x1, x2, x3 minus del of x0, x1, x2 divided by x3 minus x0. So, from here it is clear that this is x1, x2, x3. That is 21, and minus x0, x1, x2 is 15, and for this 15 and 21, fourth value is 10, its diagonally, lower diagonal and upper diagonal values are 10 minus 4 gives us 6. And 21 minus 15 are 6, so here we will get 1. Now for 27 and 21, we will get that 27 minus 21. 27 lower diagonal value is 11, and 21 upper diagonal value is 5, because 100 is in front of 5. So here we will get 11 minus 5, that is equal to 6. 6 divided by 6 give us answer 1. Similarly for 27 and 33, 33 minus 27 divided by 23 diagonal elements is 13, and 27 diagonal element is 7. 13 minus 7 is 6. 33 minus 27 is 6. Here answer is 1. Now for S4, delta 4, now value of delta 4 can be find out 1 minus 1, delta 4 value can be find out by using formula delta 4 is equal to delta of x0, x1, x2, x3 and x4. So it is equal to delta of x1, x2, x3, x4 minus delta of x0 to x3, x0, x1, x2, x3 and divided by x4 minus x0. Now when we are talking about delta of x1, x2, x3, x4 is 1 minus delta of x0, x1, x3 is 1, and 1's diagonally element is 11 and upper is diagonally element is 4, so 0 divided by 7 give us answer 0. When we are talking about these two, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. And for this one, lower diagonal element is 13, and this one, upper diagonal element is 5. So from here, we will get 0 divided by 8, that is equal to 0. Now, for next divided difference of this 0 and 0 is also 0. So this is the way that how we can formulate divided difference table. Now this is delta 1 x naught x 1, this is delta x naught x 1 x 2, delta x naught x 1 x 2 x 3 is equal to 1, x naught x 1 x 2 x 3 x 4 delta is 0, and similarly delta of x naught x 1 x 2 x 3 x 4 x 5 is also 0. Now we will put these values into the formula of Newton divided difference and we will get the polynomial. So put these values into formula. Putting values, we will get for this formula, we will get from here f of x is equal to f of x naught, f of x naught, that is value of y naught. So y naught value is 48, because f of x is equal to y and f of x naught is equal to y naught. So y naught value is 48 plus x minus x naught, x naught is 4, x minus 4 into first divided difference. This is first divided difference, this is second divided difference, third divided difference, fourth divided difference, and this is last, that is fifth divided difference. So now it is easy to put values here. X minus x naught is 4 and first divided difference is 52 plus x minus 4, x minus 5, because this is x1, x naught, x1, x2, x3, x4 and x5. This is value of y naught, y1, y2, y3, y4 and y5. So del 2 value is 15 plus x minus 4, x minus 5, x minus 7, x minus 4, x minus 5, x minus 7 into delta 3 is 1 plus x minus 4, x minus 5, x minus 7, x minus 10 and delta 4 is equal to 0 plus x minus 4, x minus 5, x minus 7, x minus 10, x minus 11 and del 5 is also 0. So from here we can see that this is 52, del 1 value, del 2 value, del 3 value, this is del 4 value and this is del 5 value. Now in del 4 and del 5, 0 multiply with all terms will give us 0 value and we will get here 48 plus x minus 4 into 52 plus x minus 4, x minus 5 into 15 plus x minus 4, x minus 5, x minus 7 into 1. Now we have to simplify. This and we will get that 48 plus 52x minus 208 plus x minus 4 multiply by x minus 5 will give us x square minus 9x plus 20 into 15. Plus x minus 4 will firstly written as it is. Firstly, multiply x minus 4, x minus 5, we will get x square minus 9x plus 20 into x minus 7. Now, further simplification gives us this further simplification will give us48 plus 52x minus 208 plus 15x square minus 135x plus 300 plus x cube minus 9x square plus 20x minus 7x square plus 63x minus 140. Now adding same variable value we will get x cube. And only we will get from here, this is 5x square, 15x square, and this is 9 minus 7 is 16x square. So from here we will get minus x square. Values of x by adding we'll get, this is 52 plus 20, 72 plus 63. Give us 135x minus 135x and for constant we will get 300 and negative of constant is minus 208 minus 140 minus 208 minus 140 will give us minus 348 and this is plus 48. From here we can get these two terms cancel each other and by adding this term also cancel each other. So we will get x cube minus x square is equal to f of x, that is the required polynomial. Now by putting different values of x, we can find out different values of function. As it is given in question that we have to find out value of f18, 8 and f15. So f8 can be written as 8 cube minus 8 square, taking eight square common into 8 minus 1. 64 into 7 will give us answer 448. And here is 15 cube minus 15 square. Either evaluate it or by applying formula. 3375 minus 225 will give us required answer. That is value of function is 3150. That is F8 value. And this is the value of F15. That is all about today's lecture that we have to done.